Hello everybody, today I'm gonna compare for you Trading22 to eToro and tell you which one is the best that you should use. Of course, it all comes down to personal preferences at the end of the day, but we're gonna speak about a few different topics that you might be interested in. For example, the market products that they offer, how much fees you're gonna have to pay and all that, that you can find in the description down below with timestamps if you wanna go to a specific one. But right now, we're gonna start with the inventory of market products. So why not starting with eToro, that has about 800 stocks that you can purchase on their app, which is pretty good, right? You have access to 800 stocks available on the platform, which might seem like a lot, but if you compare it to Trading22, they have about more than 3,000 stocks available to purchase. So there's a big difference between eToro and Trading22 for this. But yeah, of course, if you want more stocks available for you to purchase, Trading22 is gonna be way better than eToro for this one. Now, both of them also offers ETFs, which is, in my opinion, one of the most important market products that an investing app has to offer, because if you don't know what it is, what an ETF regroups multiple stocks in just one purchase that you can make that is managed by other people. That's an exchange traded fund, ETF. So that's a great way for you to diversify your portfolio in multiple holdings and have an average price that's pretty low with an ETF, and then you're gonna see great return. You can have dividend yields and all that stuff. So really, ETFs are really important, but you can buy ETFs on both eToro and Trading22. Actually, Trading22 has a little bit more ETFs available than eToro, and the difference between the two is actually pretty low. Like, for example, if you compare eToro, they have about 200 ETFs available for you to purchase from, and on Trading22, on the other hand, they have about a bit more than 200. I think it's more than 300 available. But overall, if you want to invest into ETFs only, well, both are pretty good with that. So we spoke about the number of stocks available and if they have ETFs or not, but what other kind of market products can you buy on each of these apps? Well, let's start with eToro, that has, as we said, stocks and ETFs, but they also have way more market products. They also have cryptos, which we're gonna speak about a little bit later on in this video, because that's a strange way that they use cryptos on eToro. But you also have commodities like oil, for example, you have currencies, you have indexes, but most of the market products that you're gonna find on eToro are actually based on CFDs, so more trading oriented than long-term investments. So to come back to cryptos, well, the way it works on eToro, you can't really own any of these cryptocurrencies. For example, if you want to invest into Bitcoin, so like owning a percentage of a Bitcoin or full Bitcoin if you want to, you can't do that on eToro. You can just invest on the value of the cryptocurrency. So that's a bit of a bummer on the way it works. You can't really own any of these currencies. You can just invest in the stock prices. But hey, I guess you still have access to the price of these cryptos, so you can technically invest into them. But if you want to find a better way of investing into cryptos, I have a video on the channel about the three best ways for you to invest into cryptos from Europe that you can go and find right here. And now to come back to Trading22, what kind of market products do they offer? Well, actually, it's a little bit different on Trading22 because you have access to two different kind of accounts. The first one is the invest account, in which you don't pay any commission. You can buy stocks for free and all that stuff. We're gonna speak about this later on with the fees, but you have the invest account that's free of commission, and the CFD account that's more for trading, in which you're gonna have to pay fees on it. So for the invest account, you have access to stocks, ETFs, bonds, indexes, and funds. And that's pretty much it on the invest account. So for all these, you don't pay any fees. Now, when it comes to the CFD account, you have access, for example, Forex, CFDs, you also have cryptos that you can use just like eToro, and also options that you can find on the CFD account on Trading22. So when you compare both, you pretty much see that they offer the same kind of market products. Now, it all comes down to how much of these market products they offer. For example, we saw with stocks and ETFs that Trading22 offers more than eToro, but they have the same category of market products available. Now let's go and speak about the fees, which is, in my opinion, the most important aspect of each investment app, because you don't want to go blind into an app and they're gonna charge you every time you do everything. So let's start with Trading22, which is, in my opinion, the most interesting one when it comes to the fees, because as I said before, with the invest account, you don't pay any commissions on stocks, ETFs, bonds, and indexes, for example, which is great if you want to invest for the long term. You can buy an ETF, buy a stock, and hold it long term without paying any charges on that. But if you want to invest into the other category of market price that they have, you're gonna have to pay a CFD fee every single time, which kind of sucks, but that's the way trading works. So in the description of this video, you're gonna find links to all the fees that Trading22 will charge you on the CFD account, and also same thing for eToro. Speaking about eToro, they also have no commissions on stocks and ETFs, which is great. Just like Trading22, you can invest into them without being charged fees, which we all like. But a few different things from eToro. For example, you're gonna have to pay an inactivity fee if you are inactive on your account for more than a year. So of course, that's really long, 1 year. So if you are inactive for a full year, you're gonna have to pay a certain amount of money. Probably won't happen because, well, everybody likes to watch from time to time what's going on with their account, buy new things, sell new things. So that's not really a big deal, I would say, especially because I think it's like $10 for 1 year. So it's really not that big too. And also the CFD fees will be way different than Trading22, so everything will be linked down below. Now, another really important thing about these investment apps, and that's the security. You don't want to go on an app that is not secured enough. You don't want to lose money with these apps. So of course you want to be onto an app that is well regulated and that's well secured. So let's go through that right now. First of all, both of these platforms are regulated by the FCA, which is the Financial Conduct Authority from the UK, which is a really good regulator. So that's already a good point for both of them. Now, both of the platforms also have their own regulator in each cases, which, let's start with Trading22, for example, that is also regulated by the FSC, which is a Bulgarian financial authority, which is great. It means that they are regulated by both the FCA and the FSC. Same thing with eToro, except they are not regulated by the FSC, but by the Cyprus Security Exchange Commission, which is also one great regulator. Now, how does it work and how well your money is secured into both of these apps? First of all, if you are using eToro and you are from the UK, you are covered up to £85,000 of cash, which is great because if you have less than that, you are technically covered by the FCA. In case eToro has like a big issue and they have the whole platform going down, you'll still have about £85,000 that are regulated by the FCA, that are covered actually by the FCA. Watch out, because if you're outside of the UK, you're gonna have only about £20,000 available that are covered actually by the FCA. Now let's speak about asset security, because of course what I just spoke about was about cash. So you have these amount of cash that are covered by the FCA. Right now, if you own assets on these platforms, if you bought stocks, if you bought ETFs and the platform goes down, you are not really losing these stocks. The way it works on eToro is that they have their own personal insurance for their assets that can go up to the value of $1 million. So it means that your assets are covered by eToro in case they go down up to the value of $1 million, which is a great security. It's an immense amount of money that is covered by them, but I would like you guys to be careful about this because this is a private insurance. And at any point of time, eToro can just say, oh, we're not doing this anymore, and they can just stop it at any point because they are the one that are regulating this insurance. But they still have a pretty great security, and in case the platform goes down, you still have ways for you to get back your assets. Now, the way it works on Trading22 is pretty similar actually. For example, the £85,000 of cash in the UK, they also have it, and the £20,000 outside of the UK, they also have it. So for the cash amounts, Trading22 and eToro have the same thing. But now the way it works for asset security is different on Trading22. The way it works is that Trading22 isn't holding onto your assets, which means that if Trading22 goes bust, you won't lose any of your assets because they will all be held by Interactive Broker, which, if you guys don't know, is an even bigger trading platform, investing platform that exists. And that's actually one of the biggest in the world, which is great because if Trading22 goes bust, your assets will be held by Interactive Brokers and you can get them back, all of them. So I really like the way Trading22 operates with security of assets. It's a little bit different than eToro, but I would say it's a little bit more secured. You have more chances of actually getting your assets back than on eToro, but both of these have some pretty great security. Now let's speak about user experience, because it's really important for someone, especially beginners, to go on these apps and to feel like home pretty much, so that they know what to do and they're not losing money on stupid features that they don't know how they work. Both of these platforms are actually great. They have great interfaces, but they are quite different. For example, Trading22 is way simpler, I would say, than eToro, but eToro, on the other hand, since it's more CFD based, more trading oriented, has more of a trading look on its platform, which makes sense for the kind of customer they have. But if you are an investor, especially a beginner, eToro will not be as easy as Trading22 to use. But once you know a little bit about these apps, they are pretty easy to maneuver and easy to use. So I would really not care that much about user friendliness for both of these apps, except if you are a really new person to investing, a really beginner when it comes to that, eToro will not be the best choice in my opinion. But what about customer service, which is also a really important thing when you invest your money into an app? You don't want to be lost in it, and when you ask customer service, they just don't answer you, right? So what about customer service for both of these apps? So let's start with eToro, that has a decent customer service that could be improved, because I saw a lot of people actually complaining about the fact that sometimes eToro customer service is just offline and you can't contact them. So if you have an emergency at this time, it can be really stressful for you to be in this situation. But on eToro, you have access to a live chat, and you unfortunately don't have access to a phone support, which is really helpful when you are really stressed about something that's happening with a portfolio, for example. And Trading22, on the other hand, is pretty similar. You also have access to a live chat and no phone support, so that's the exact same thing as eToro, but you also have access to email support, which can be helpful in case you are not finding help with the live chat, for example. I saw less complaint about Trading22 than with eToro, mostly with the fact that sometimes eToro was just offline with the customer service. But overall, they have a pretty similar way of handling customer service and a pretty decent one for both of them. Now, I just wanted to speak about the unique feature because, for example, eToro has one great feature that you can't see anywhere else, that's called the social trading platform. It kind of works like a social media in which you can follow people, like literally follow people that have their account on them, and follow their portfolio. So you can allocate a percentage of your portfolio to follow the exact same trades that this guy or this girl is doing. And in my opinion, that's a great way for you to diversify your trades and what you're doing with a portfolio. But on the other hand, there is a downside to this, because you are not really handling your money yourself. You're just telling the platform to follow the exact same trade that this person is doing. And if the person has a bad day and they lose 20% while trading, well, your portfolio will also lose 20%. So if you are a beginner and you see that somebody is having great results on the platform of eToro, you can maybe follow them, but always remember to put a small percentage of your portfolio to follow the portfolio of somebody else, because if they have trouble, you're gonna have trouble too. But if they do great, you're also gonna do great. So overall, that's a pretty interesting thing to do, but it's more CFD oriented. So if you want to invest into the long term, like I do, this feature is not really the most helpful one, because it's more like trading stocks and a quick profit. But that's a really innovative way of using kind of a social media approach to investing. So if you guys are interested into this feature, only eToro has it. But remember that it can be dangerous, and I would not recommend putting all your money like that into like following somebody. So what is my overall thoughts on both of these platforms? Because in my opinion, they're both pretty good. It will all come down to personal preferences pretty much. But what I would say is that if you are more into long-term investing, Trading22 might be a better idea, because they have no commissions on stocks and ETFs, just like eToro, but they don't have any inactivity fees, and they have really like a simple approach onto the app and the way it works. On the other hand, if you are more interested into CFDs, cryptos, more like trading oriented mentality, eToro might be a more interesting choice for you. And also they have their social trading platform, which is really interesting in my opinion. Now, I personally use Trading22, but it all comes down to what you want. Now, you can go and watch one of these two videos right here in case you are interested into these topics. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Click the subscribe button if you liked it, and of course, like it if you like it, makes sense. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.